Hello dear students, now we are resuming with our topic on grinding machine. The part 1 of this video is already uploaded on your Moodle website as well as on YouTube. You can refer to part 1 video before moving ahead with this part 2 video. So in part 1 we have discussed what is the principle of grinding machine, and then we have discussed various types of grinding machine, in which we have seen the portable grinding machine, then belt type grinding machine, then center or cylindrical grinding machine, and now we are moving ahead with the other types of grinding machine and the grinding operations. So the next type of grinding machine which we are going to discuss is centerless grinding. So what is the basic principle behind this centerless grinding is two grinding wheels which are mounted directly on the motor, which is rotated by using some power, electrical power, and one of the wheel is provided with power and one of the wheel is stationary wheel. So you can see in this particular diagram here, the workpiece is given over here, then the rotating grind wheel, which is powered one, which is on this particular location, and the control wheel, which is just for the supporting this particular workpiece in order to rotate that workpiece and at the same time obtain certain grinding surface. So this particular type of grinding operation is performed only while performing the external grinding or internal grinding for the cylindrical parts. So if we are not having any type of cylindrical surface or cylindrical part to be ground, if I need to grind a cylinder instead of cylindrical, I am having one cube. And if I want to grind that one of the surface of that cube, then it will be not possible to grind with the help of the centerless grinder. So what is required here is a round type of workpiece, and which is mounted against the two rotating grinding wheels, in which one of the grinding wheel will be rotated with the help of motor power supply, and another type of or another grinding wheel will be having a stationary location. The provision is made such that the rotational motion from the driven grinding wheel is transferred to the control wheel, and in here the workpiece as well as both the grinding wheels are rotated in order to obtain the grinding surface. So from this particular diagram also you can see this explanation or justify this explanation. So this is the one grinding wheel, this is the another grinding wheel, these two grinding wheels are having one work blade. This work blade's work is to just position these rotating workpiece, and then as we give rotation to this grinding wheel, the workpiece gets rotated in anti-clockwise direction, and then grinding wheel, which is a regulating wheel, it is also rotated in the clockwise direction. So both of these wheels will be having abrasive particles mounted or embedded on it, and those abrasive particles are responsible for removing the material from the workpiece. So a centerless grinder is a type of cylindrical grinder which uses two rotary wheels to secure the workpiece in a place. Okay, then unlike the centered grinder, a centerless grinder does not make use of a spindle. So we are not having spindle. Spindle is made for the means, as we are not having center, so there is no point of spindle. No doubt the motion is transferred to the grinding wheel, but that is not through the spindle. Okay, then the speed of the rotation of the wheels determines at what rate the material is removed. So if we are, obviously we can understand from this diagram, if we are rotating the workpiece at very slow rotation, then we can say that the workpiece is also, the material removal from the workpiece is also through that particular rate. Okay, and then if we are we want to remove the workpiece, material removed from the workpiece should be at a very high rate, then we have to provide a higher rotation to the grinding wheel. Then tool and cutter grinders. So basically these type of grinders are used for resharpening of the various tool. As we have seen that single point cutting tool, in milling operations we have seen the multiple point cutting tools. So we have seen that n number of milling cutting tools, then single point cutting tools, drilling tools are there. We are going to see in upcoming unit number 6, we are going to see drilling operation, then broaching operation, then single point cutting tools, multi point cutting tools, milling cutters, or normal cutters. So all these needs resharpening. So for that resharpening purpose, we can use this tool and cutter grinders. So basically here, this is the universal type of tool and cutter grinder which is shown in this diagram. So what is happening here in this particular type of grinder, we are having various provisions in order to grind the various internal and external surfaces available on the cutter and tools. And this particular light is given so that we can see the surface which we are grinding, whether that surface has been obtained a specified degrees of finish or specified degrees of angle or not. That can be seen from this light. Then this motor is mounted, in which is giving directly motion through the gearbox to the grinding wheel. And then we are having this particular grinding wheel can be rotated at certain angles through this fulcrum point, and work table also can be swiveled at various direction, and feed and depth of cut can be given through the beds. Okay, so this is the type of the tool which is used for resharpening of tool and cutters. So a tool and cutter grinder makes a use of a CNC machine tool up to 5 axis and a multiple grinding wheel. These devices are used for sharpening and producing a milling cutter such as drills, end mills and step tools. It is also widely used for producing the tool needed in the woodworking and metalworking operations. Okay, so you can see here, this is your light. Okay, this is your light which is there, and this is the fulcrum point about which we are talking. This is the motor, and this is my grinding wheel. This is the work table. Okay, so these are the things which are given over here. So now let us see what are the various parts of a standard grinding machine. So let us see one by one what are the various parts of a grinding machine. So you can see from this diagram, this is the basic diagram for the grinding machine, in which you can see this is the center type of grinding, or the we can say that it is a cylindrical type of grinding machine, in which we can see various parts. So headstock is there, wheel head is there, tailstock is there, between headstock and tailstock workpiece is there, grinding wheel is there. Then various things, that is the lower table, adjustable dock, table movement, base, all these things are given over here. So let us see one by one what are the various parts of the grinding machine. First of all, base or bed. Base or bed of every machine, as we know that it is used for transferring the all the forces which are coming onto the workpiece while we are pressing, we are performing that machining operation. So it is a cast iron casting rest on the floor and supports the other parts which are mounted on it. Okay, so basically it is made up of cast iron so that it should have a high bearing, load bearing capacity. Then the base houses the table drive mechanism, and on the top of the base, accurately machined guideways are provided at right angles to the table to the slide on it. Okay, so the base is housing for all the components, and then the drive mechanisms on the top of the base are accurately machined guideways. So on the base, top of the base, we are having machined guideways which are at right angles to provide a sliding motion to the table which is mounted above the base. So there are two tables, a lower table and the upper table. The lower table provides the transfer movement to the work by sliding the sliding over the guideways on the bed, which can be moved by hand or a power, and the upper table pivots at its center over the sliding table and provide with headstock and tailstock, and this can be positioned at a position along the table to hold the workpiece. So you can see here, this is the base and this is the table. This is the rotary type of grinder, so the table is rotary here. The upper table, this I'm talking about this table. Okay, then the upper table can be swiveled and clamped for grinding straight and tapered surface. Okay, so we will see this particular type of, we can see this particular type of operation here. So this is the adjustable table dogs which are used for swiveling these. These are the adjustable table dogs which are used for swiveling the workpiece mounted on the table. Okay, so this is the lower table and this is the upper table. Okay, then headstock. Headstock is the fixed over the bed and it supports the workpiece by means of a dead center and drives it by means of a dog, or it may hold the workpiece in a chuck and drives it. So there are various operations that can be, that are to be performed by headstock. Its basic operation is to hold the workpiece and provide the rotary motion to the workpiece. Either it is powered or it will be not powered. Dead stock can be also called as the headstock. Then tailstock is the, always it is a not powered and it is used for making certain adjustments, certain angular adjustment, or providing a support motion between if I want to mount the job between the centers. So the tailstock can be adjusted and fixed in any required position to accommodate the different length of the workpieces. Then wheel head, it consists of a grinding wheel and a driving motor. So the grinding wheel is mounted on the wheel head. This is the wheel head. So this complete part is wheel head, and on which this grinding wheel is mounted. The wheel head mounted on a slide at the rear end of the base and moves perpendicularly to the table base by hand or powered to feed the grinding wheel of the work. So this wheel head is powered and it is fed to the towards the tailstock, towards the workpiece, which is mounted between the centers of the headstock and the tailstock. Then crossfeed. So this particular diagram, I found it very suitable for providing you description on the crossfeed. Crossfeed is the movement which is the movement of the table in x and y directions. So this is the lever, crossfeed lever, feed lever, you can see here, feed lever. So this lever is used for providing the crossfeed to the table. The grinding wheel can be fed to the work by engagement of the crossfeed control lever by hand or the power. So this can be moved with the help of hand or with the help of external power. So this complete diagram deals with all the detailed parts of the standard grinding machine. Okay, then grinding machine operations. So surface grinding operation, it is used to make a flat surface. The rotating grinding wheel and removes the material from the top surface of the workpiece and gives a flat look. So surface grinder are used for providing this particular or machining with the help of the surface grinding operation. Then cylindrical grinding operation, these are the grinding operations performed only on a cylindrical jobs. The cylindrical grinding operation are of two types, external and internal cylindrical grinding. So we have seen the cylindrical type of grinder machine, so on which we can perform all these two operations, that is external and internal cylindrical grinding. So external cylindrical grinding is nothing but when we need to remove the excess material from the outer surface of the workpiece, then we perform an external grinding operation. And internal grinding operation is done for smoothening the internal surface or hole or any of the cylindrical workpiece. So this is the self-explanatory type of thing, that is what is external cylindrical grinding and internal cylindrical grinding. Then centerless grinding can be performed on the centerless grinding. In this type of grinding, the operation of the two grinding wheels are fitted parallel with a little 5 to 10 degrees angle, and the angle is provided to get the longitudinal motion of the workpiece. So a cylindrical rod is entered between the two grinding wheels. Due to the tilted angle, the workpiece is automatically passed through a wheels and we got a smooth surface. So we have seen this cylindrical grinding process in this particular diagram. Okay, so in which we have tilted these two grinding wheels at certain angles, 5 to 10 degrees, in order to provide a motion to the workpiece. So that is it about this. All these are the topics that I want to cover in this particular video. So you can go through these references or the things which are available. These complete slides will be available on your Moodle website. You can click on the links, respective links, and go through the various references which I have used for preparation of this video. Then thank you very much.